Hey guys, today we're going to be making a potato salad. It's not a special, nothing special. The only thing different about my potato salad is I make my own mayonnaise. And I'm going to show you how to do that today. What you're going to need is eggs, of course. Now these came from my chickens. This is yard eggs, fresh yard eggs. Red potatoes. I like red potatoes because you don't have to peel them. It's very nutritional. I like the red potatoes with the peelings on them. You're going to need pepper, salt, oil of any kind, any vegetable oil will work, and vinegar. And that's basically all you will need for my potato salad. All right, what we're doing right now is I got my potatoes on. I just turned them on. Now I'm going to do my potatoes and my eggs in separate pots. I'm going to let them come to a boil, and I'm going to let my water for my eggs come to a boil. I do not put my eggs in until it comes to a boil. Okay, for fresh yard eggs, there's an air pocket. And if you look at an egg, you got your pointy end, and then you got your fat end on this side. Well, in an egg, on the fat end is where your air bubble is at. Okay? So, with fresh yard eggs that are 1, 2, 3, 4 days old, right? You turn your egg upside down with the fat end facing up. You take a regular pin. You put your pin in between two fingers, put that over the top. What you want to do is you want to poke a hole through the shell only. Just through the shell only, and you can feel it, okay? So you got to do this with all of your eggs before you boil them. That way the hot water will get in there and release that it'll release the air, and the hot water will get behind that fibers and release it whenever you peel it.
All right, guys, my water's boiling, ready for my eggs, okay? Now, I'm going to put these eggs in there while it's boiling. Maybe when it cools off a little bit, you'll be able to see the air actually escape from the egg. See the air coming out of the egg? That means the water is going inside the egg and the air is escaping. That's going to go around the membrane. You only need to do this for fresh yard eggs, okay guys? Eggs out of the store, there's no need to do that because they're aged. And the older an egg gets, the bigger the air pocket gets. So when they're fresh, you have a small air pocket and most of the membrane is stuck to the shell.
Alright, now in preparation for when I boil my eggs, I gotta get some ice. And I'm gonna get it and I'm gonna fill it up with water. This is gonna be my ice bath for my eggs. That's gonna cool them down real quick. After they're boiled, we're gonna put them in here for about 5 minutes until they're completely cool. Alright, guys, the potatoes are done. I'm gonna shut them off. We're gonna bring them over to the sink and run some cold water over them. I don't like a mushy potato salad. I like a good chunky potato salad. It's soft like a boiled potato, and you can eat it like on a crawfish ball, but I don't like it mushy. So you'll see what I'm talking about when I get it. My eggs are done boiling. I boiled them for about 16 minutes. Now what I'm going to do is take all of these eggs, and I'm going to put them in this ice water. I'm going to let them sit for 5 minutes until they're completely cool. Once we're done with the cool off of the eggs, I'm going to take one at a time and I'm going to bring them back to this hot water. And I'm going to keep them in there for about 10 seconds just to warm them back up. And then I'm going to peel them. Now again, what you need to realize, I don't do this for regular store-bought eggs, okay? I only do this for yard eggs. If you have a farm and you have some eggs, every day you get eggs, your eggs will be hard to peel if you boil them like you do store-bought eggs.
So this is the only way you can peel a yard egg without it messing up.
Okay guys, I'm gonna start doing these one at a time. I'm gonna put them back in the hot water. I'm gonna let that kind of heat up a little bit, and it's gonna expand and contract, and then we'll see what happens. All right, that's pretty hot. Look at that. That's a yard egg that normally you wouldn't be able to peel. All my eggs are boiled. I'm going to separate the white from the yolk. I want the yolks only. So I'm going to take all 8 of these eggs and I'm going to separate them and then chop these up later. I'll be right back. I got the potatoes and the egg whites in the bowl. I got half an onion, white onion, that's been finely chopped. Okay, so I'm gonna put that aside. Now for the moment y'all have all been waiting for, the mayonnaise. Okay, first I'm gonna take the fork and I'm gonna smash up the egg yolks. You want to do this first. Mash up your egg yolks. Okay. Now this is very important. The two most important things in this. You need one raw egg yolk. If you don't use one raw egg yolk, it will not turn. Okay? So one raw egg yolk. You're going to separate. This is the single most important thing about this whole mayonnaise. One raw egg yolk. Now, of course, you're going to need oil, but I'll get to that in a minute. You're going to put your little black pepper just to kind of cover it. A little bit of kosher salt. I like kosher salt. Okay. Now the vinegar. Okay. So you're going to start out with about a tablespoon or so. All right. You need about a tablespoon of water. You can actually take the cap of the vinegar, fill it up. You don't need much water at all, but it is very important that you have the water and the raw yolk. If not, it will not turn, it will not get creamy. And then your next ingredient, of course, is oil. Now you're going to start out with about a cup of oil. Okay, you don't want to start out with too much oil. So watch real close here. It's going to get real creamy.
go, see it? It's gonna get creamy. Now once you get it to cream up like that, you add a little bit of oil at a time. And the more oil you add, the more mayonnaise, it'll expand. Now once you get that, now it's to taste, guys. You got to actually taste it. You gotta... I think it needs a little bit more vinegar. Remember, don't put too much. Needs a little bit more black pepper too. I'm thinking this is going to be enough mayonnaise for this. So now I'm just going to get it to my taste. Okay, the mayonnaise is complete. So just to recap, I had 8 fresh farm eggs, just a yolk, after they were boiled, and 8 eggs made that much, as you can see. You can see the comparison. This is a 2-quart bowl, or a quart and a half, I should say. No, 2 quarts. So this one here, I'd say that's about 2 pints. 2 cups, 2.5 cups of mayonnaise, okay? With 8 egg yolks. So now I'm gonna mix it. You see how yellow that is? That's what fresh yard eggs are good for. You don't have to put any food coloring or mustard, or a lot of people like mustard in it. I'll eat it. It's not my favorite. I like regular, real mayonnaise, homemade. Now I'm gonna mix this up. I got my raw onion in there. Now, once you do this, time to taste it. Let's see what happens here. With the potatoes, and the onion, and the mayonnaise. It don't get much better than that. That's some good stuff.